Since the beginning of their existence, humans have never wondered how nor why dreams have been taking place in their minds. In addition, they have neither wondered about what was really behind the experience of dreaming. Until that strange Monday early morning, Genius was a clever boy who used to get up quickly after the first ring. However, that morning, he remained embraced to his pillow, listening to the clock sounds with suspicion. After a while, he began to dream, and a wide open space appeared before his eyes. Standing just in front of him was a great golden gate suspended in the air. The entrance to the gate was surrounded by majestic sounds of choirs and bells. All of a sudden, the gate was opened and Genius was captured by an incredible vortex that led him to the huge entrance. At the end of that stormy moment, Genius saw through the haze two strange masses slowly taking shape before his eyes. The figures seemed to be two beautiful women, with sweet smiles upon their faces. With a delicate whisper, the women welcomed him.
Well,
the situation, because he wasn't understanding anything about it. He couldn't yet realize that what was happening to him was the result of his dreaming. After this first meeting, a new scenery appeared in front of him. There was an infinite queue of people slowly proceeding onwards, step by step, toward an indefinite point on the horizon. Genius joined the queue, and still in disbelief, asked for an explanation from the person in front of him.
Really?
two brand new friends found themselves in a very long and funny colored train, where the twin spirits grouped in pairs were sitting. The train started unexpectedly its race, and immediately reached an incredible speed. In fact, after some minutes, the train eventually reached its final destination, the Twin Spirit Land. The station master was an old man that, since the birth of time, has always greeted the new twin spirits at their arrival to the land. Well, this place was definitely amazing. The ground was like a big maze suspended in the air. Scattered along its tight corridors, there were many numbered control stations where every twin spirit was slowly taking his place. Each control station featured a comfortable armchair and a widescreen through which the twin spirit could control the fantasies of his owner. Furthermore, there was a big control panel installed behind the screen. On the panel, there were archives of every possible fantasy, which were ready to be used for the creation of a dream. Genius and his twin spirit found the others, who had previously arrived and were already at work. Meanwhile, many dreams were still continuing on the screens. A tall and imposing shape appeared, making all the twin spirits run quickly in order to take their places. This imperious person was on time for the usual speech he performed in front of the dream makers at the start of every shift. was looking at his travel mate who was starting to work. He was a real twin spirit. That was the difference between them. Genius, in fact, was staring at those controls with the utmost ignorance about how to deal with them. a tribal beat was pounding from the kingdom's shores. Then, a great procession of people dressed in vivid colors came to the Twin Spirit's sight. The ground was trembling to the joyful march of King Wild Tribe and his subjects. King Mikaos was really glad to see his old friend again.
There's something that I always do to
tribe, followed by his collaborators, entered the area, he was amazed by the majesty of Mikaos's play. But his collaborators did not miss to notice Twin Spirit number 33. He was sweating, sitting in front of a blank black screen. And this was really suspicious. Next to him was Twin Spirit number 32. He was displaying the exact view of his eyes. There was a human in that land.
Look over there!
Wild Tribes Caravan started its walk back to the African kingdom as it progressively disappeared into the horizon. King Mikaos got back to his palace too, unaware of what would soon have happened to him. That night, the European king watched over his little son. Though it was as if he were feeling anxious for some unexplainable reason, but only perceived through the sensitiveness of a father.
Thank you.
Shortly after Wild Tribe's denunciation, Mr. Main Dream, the president of the Dream League Council, summoned all the kings of the world. He summoned them in order to decide what kind of punishment should be applied in that case. After a brief discussion, that decision was taken.
Could not imagine that.
seconds after the sentence, in the still of the night, Main Dream in person, and some of the Dream League Force soldiers silently reached Mikaos's palace. The king was arrested, and his baby was sent to the toy warehouse in the Asian Dreams Kingdom. This was a terrible thing, because Mikaos knew that his son would have been destroyed. A cold tremor shook across the Twin Spirits' land. The news of King Mikaos' arrest spread quickly among the Twin Spirits, and their hearts filled with fear. They all loved so much their king. In the meantime, the Dream League's force entered the Twin Spirits' land and started to search for Twin Spirit number 32. Will the two friends solve all these troubles? To be